Well, you had your bikers, and you had your hippies, and you had your occasional redneck there as well. So it was a real mix of people, kind of countercultural 70s group in there. And it was always different, you know. But there were always bikers there, for sure. And there was always that zigzag man that was painted on the bottom of the swimming pool.
So I went down when it was empty, and Dane and I looked at this little pack of papers,
yeah,
and it was
a zigzag man.
And I said, 12 foot tall, 5 foot wide, I can do that. And so I made this zigzag man on the bottom.
Perfect zigzag man on the bottom.
And you could see it from the bar. When the pool was totally clean, you could totally see it. You sit in the bar and see this giant zigzag man.
I live on the oldest road in the Santa Cruz Mountains, which is Mountain Charlie Road. And so it's about a mile from the chateau. So back in the 70s, we went there quite a bit and saw a lot of great bands there too.
The Jefferson Airplane defined the San Francisco sound in the late 1960s. But in 1969, after years of performing her legendary vocals, singer Grace Slick required throat surgery and the Airplane was put on hiatus. Guitarist Jorma Kekkonen and bassist Jack Cassidy formed Hot Tuna as a side project to Jefferson Airplane, and they loved to play the Chateau Liberte. With Papa John Creech on fiddle and Sammy Piazza on drums, Hot Tuna's sound was live electrified blues. Tuna's love for performing led them to record the live album, First Pull Up, Then Pull Down, at the Chateau Liberte in 1971. It was the only major label live album to ever be recorded there.
Was it time I once came running down the street?
I went the 3 days they recorded their second album. Three of my friends with our fake IDs got in. We got there at 5 so we could get right in front each night. And I actually, one of my big claims to fame, you know, you can hear me going, yeah, after this great harp solo on the record. So I always cherish that as a memory of the Chateau, you know. And being right in front, watching those guys just jam like, no.
Papa John Creech had a successful career as a solo artist and worked up to his death in 1994. He was 76 years old.
You know, one night would be Hot Tuna, which is like back then, you know, late 60s, those guys were still fresh off Airplane and just, you know, burning hot. Most of the bands that we saw, some of them were pickup bands with the people that I just mentioned. Jack Cassidy would play in somebody else's set, or they would play in theirs, and that's what I really liked about it. It was, the structure was fairly loose, all the musicians were really good.
Jorma and Jack never have stopped playing together as Hot Tuna, and were still touring as this film was being made. The huge success of the Doobies and the stories of their humble chateau beginnings, as well as the release of the live Hot Tuna album, had exposed millions of music fans around the world to the Chateau Liberte. As its reputation grew, More people showed up at the Chateau Liberte, and it became a thriving commune. And more bands showed up too. The Grateful Dead's legendary frontman, Jerry Garcia, spent a lot of time at the Chateau Liberte. Jerry and keyboardist Merl Saunders played the Chateau Liberte many times to a packed house. Garcia reportedly lived at the Chateau Liberte for a while and played many other Santa Cruz area shows at places like The Barn and Town & Country Lodge. The Saunders Garcia Band played from 1971 to 1975. Jerry Garcia would go on to play some of the biggest tours in rock history with the Dead. Both Jerry and Merle continued to play numerous acts and projects until their deaths. Another Dead spin-off band to play the Chateau Liberte was Kingfish with Bob Weir. The Kingfish lineup included Robbie Hodnott, Matthew Kelly, Dave Torberg, Barry Last, Chris Harold, and Bob Weir, of course. Their repertoire was similar to the Dead's, but as Kingfish, they could play smaller rooms like the Chateau Liberte. During the production of this film, an unknown recording of Kingfish live at the Chateau Liberte was discovered, and that is what you're hearing now.